have been like agreed upon fairly easily the past few years because trophies pair nice with one. Because it's like in the spot where the copy bird always flies over and sits in front of, and it's a really good bird reuniting spot. And then this year, or last year, we added Zizu and did like the spot here square. And everybody agreed on that because we were all obsessed with it. And then this year, our new blind, we named after Sue. So it's called Sue Shanty. And it has little ukuleles on the side and little musical notes pieces on it. It's right, the perfect like puffin and razor. Now, so we just started like breaking them the middle of the day at the bar. Having appetizers, this is really fun. That's my new favorite thing with the field. The bar overlooks and the dome. And you sit there. In the morning, you get the light behind you, and you just get the water. And then, in the evening, you get the sunset. But the camp and hill is the bright side of the sunset. There's like one younger fisherman who is like the son of the guy that we talked with a lot. And he's sometimes the other one. He's like usually the only one out there. And like he thinks that's almost very gross. Probably Saturday mornings. Yacht was like it had to be like a $10 million yacht, and it was just like right next to the out there with all the puffins. And the crew guy was getting up to drone. And I, because we were looking at them with binoculars, so we were doing puffin productivity. And I went, like, I saw the drone in my binoculars. So, like, I started walking to them, because they were so close, but they could easily see me. I was just like, no, no. And they stopped, and then they left.
What?
They just left. It was incredible. I couldn't believe it. Like, you could. I've had so many shitty experiences with Christian people when I was doing shorebirds and keepers when I was a kid taught, that I thought for sure they'd just ignore me. I mean, what?
I want a device that, like, kills drones. Just push it and fall.
Did you get any at lunch? So you know when you have a fish and you just cover it. was a shit. My grandfather ate something like that. He would probably do a lot of fishing. He was always mad. We go out to the rocks, we pass that line consistently until we catch the fish, and when that's up,
that's how it's brought up to doing.
Sitting up there for hours and hours and hours, until I got a flat eider duck. Oh my god, bad noise right in the summer. So when Sue and Kristen were over the island with me, we might run right in front of the cabin. Like, there's multiple places where you can shoot for yourself. But from the porch, we set up this little range that's 40 yards. And we have this piece of wood, and we drilled like holes in it. And we have these rock pieces that are left there. And we drew faces.
Thank you.
it's like massive instances that I've had with the fisheries.
Probably.
Driving a big fisheries truck from Boston.
Oh, yeah.
That one cold, blistery morning. Then you get time to do this. Are you still working?
Yeah, but I'm not going to seal until the middle of September.
Oh.
No.
But you're still working for the fish and wildlife?
No, I'm graduating at UMass. So
oh, all right.
It was the UMass.
Yeah.
I'll work on this. Yeah. done and putting that. That's below my standards. This is like at my standards. Even the black bit. If it was custom. I would get any, but I probably shave that. Mainly because I don't know what's going on. I'm not like that afraid of molds. In fact, I think some molds are probably kind of free. Go on the roof.
Yeah, sure.
Do the old photo, National Geographic photo of the day. Wait. It was such a bizarre situation though, with like the ownership of the photo.
I know, like,
you can't even get the people that are in the photo without like signing some piece of paper.
I'm sorry about that.
Yeah. Will be gone if I'm like bird banding on the side too, I see all the photos from them. They seem to have like such a perfect look. literally was 25,000 observations of bird died. And only that 25,000 was in clear birds. That's baffling to me. Other people think that leaf terns are way cuter.
Yeah.
Thank you. stuff to research the entire bottom. But apparently we might get something like this. How did she get the name?
Well, I asked Brian Benedict. He said there was a mechanic who air conditioned. And she was bouncy. So he named her.
That's awesome. We were wondering if it was someone mentioned. Oh, I asked Will if he mentioned Erica.
It was Erica.
Like, I don't know. Maybe it was like Brian Benedict's like old girlfriend, like high school girlfriend or something. I don't know. I might put that and paint pen on there.
You need to.
Because I have no idea.
Name it. Bagel.
The orca bagel.
That would be different.
You know what's happening?
I think I was supposed to bring it.
What time is it now?